Hello everyone, welcome to the very first video on this channel. I'm Sonakshi and today I'll be giving this boring balcony a new look. So stay tuned. Let's begin by sanding the furniture. I bought this outdoor furniture 2 years back from IKEA in my previous apartment. After the sanding is done, wipe off the furniture with a clean dry cloth and then with a wet cloth to make sure all the dust is removed. So the next step is to apply a coat of primer. It is very important to prime the wood to provide consistent base for the top coats of paint. If you paint a surface without priming it first, you will likely need more coats of paint for adequate coverage, and the paint may not stick as well to the original surface as it would to the primer. After completely priming the wood, let it dry for 5-6 hours. For painting the furniture, I'll be using chalk paints. This one is for the chairs, and these black and white for the table. And finally, this chalk paint wax for sealing everything. Personally, I love using chalk paints as they dry really quickly and they are very durable when you add a wax or protective finish. Ideally, there's no need to prime the wood while using chalk paints, but I still did because I was switching from a dark color to a lighter one. And also because I was going to place these furnitures outdoor and I wanted strong adherence of the paint to the wood. You can completely skip that part. For the fine details, you can even use paintbrush. And once the paint has dried completely, thoroughly apply a coat of the chalk paint wax. And the chairs are done. So let's start painting the table now, for which I'll be using these black and white chalk paints. I'll be painting this table in alternate black and white patterns. First, I'll be doing all the stripes which are to be painted white. And then I'll start with the black color. Also note that you can use chalk paints even on metals. So I'm giving a fresh coat of black paint to the metal part of the table. Again, for finer details, I'm using a paintbrush. Because I was looking for a rich and intense coverage of the color, so I'm going with a second coat of the chalk paints. Now comes the best part, stenciling this table. I'll be using the stencil and the sponge. You can also use the stencil brushes available in the market. So again, I'll be using the white chalk paint to create the pattern on the black stripes. Make sure to align the stencil properly before starting off with the paint. Once it is done, take the sponge, apply very little color on it and dab it onto the stencil. Be very gentle with the process and try to hold the stencil still. You can even tape the stencil if required, but I was comfortable in doing it like this. The key to a good stencil art is to use very less color and dab it multiple times. It's a very time-taking process, but the results are amazing. For making slight corrections, I'm using the paintbrush. Finally, when the color dried completely, I sealed everything with a coat of chalk paint wax. Don't skip this part if you want the paint to last longer. I also tried drilling for the first time and added this brass hook from Amazon. Now let's clean and set up the balcony. So after setting up everything, I realized that the walls were lacking vibrancy. So let's make a colorful, easy DIY wall decor using a colorful fabric. This wooden frame is from an old canvas art which I was no longer using, and this fabric is from IKEA. So this DIY is very easy. All I'll be doing is attaching the fabric to the frame using the staple gun. In case if you want to try this DIY, just make sure that the fabric is ironed well and not having any creases. Look how easy this is. All I'm doing is just stretching the fabric and attaching it with the staple gun. So to give this DIY a clean look, be careful while wrapping the fabric around the corners. And it's done! Isn't this beautiful? So now presenting the final look of the balcony. I hope you like it. Keep watching this channel for more such ideas.